हेलो क्लास 10 चिल्ड्रन, एज यू ऑल नो आई हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट 4 ऑफ पार्ट ए एम्प्लॉयबिलिटी स्किल्स, दैट इज एंटरप्रेन्योरियल स्किल्स. नाउ टुडे आई विल बी डीलिंग विद मोर थिंग्स अबाउट दीज एंटरप्रेन्योरियल स्किल्स. नाउ एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, आई होप नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू यू. बेसिकली इट इज एन आर्ट ऑफ सेटिंग अप अ बिजनेस. नाउ सम कॉमन entrepreneurship activities related to society include social entrepreneurship, agricultural entrepreneurship, women entrepreneurship and small scale entrepreneurship. Now basically social entrepreneurship, as the name suggests, it can be understood as creation of sustainable solutions. Now what is sustainable? Sustainable means we are saving them for our future generations. Now, why we need these sustainable solutions? For solving the social problems. Social problems include problems of low reach of quality education to people, health and sanitation, unemployment, child labor, etc. So, in social entrepreneurship, now, how can education be reached? If you are opening a tuition center in an area or a school in an area where people are deprived of education, so this is an example of social entrepreneurship. Health and sanitation, it can be understood as there are no sanitation or toilet facilities in that area, so government, what it does, it opens toilets there, then it gives people money to manage the health and sanitation facilities in that area. So basically social problems like unemployment can also be solved through entrepreneurship, because basically when a company or a business is run by a person, he or she hires people and he or she gives them employment. Now next is agricultural entrepreneurship. Now agricultural entrepreneurship can be defined as being primarily related to marketing and production of inputs and products which are used in agricultural activities by the farmers. For example, various low-cost innovations in farming processes, new technologies and machines are purchased by the farmers from the entrepreneurs to help in progressing their agriculture. Then next is women entrepreneurship. Women entrepreneurship is the process where women are organizing all the factors of production, undertake the risk and provide employment to others. For example, if any women is organizing a center where other women are getting a job of sewing, tailoring, so this will be about women entrepreneurship. Then small scale entrepreneurship, basically small scale means raising the companies at a small level and then they go to high level. This is what happens is if there is no restaurant or a hospital in an area. So what does a person do? He or she first starts with this at a small level and then moves to the higher. So that is small scale. Then qualities of an entrepreneur. Now, what are the various qualities of an entrepreneur? An entrepreneur is hardworking. That means in order to be successful, he or she must be hardworking from the very early stage. The next quality is optimistic. He should have a positive approach to life. Even if there are adverse situations in business, he should not be afraid of them. Then independent, the next quality of an entrepreneur. Successful entrepreneurs like to function at their own will and rules. They dislike being guided by others. They are the masters of their own. Then energetic, the next quality of an entrepreneur. He or she must have a high level of energy. Then only he can put hard work. Then self-confident. An entrepreneur should have a strong belief in his or her abilities, that he or she can do this task. Then perseverant. Now perseverant, the quality is that even if there are failures, he or she should never quit. Successful entrepreneurs show perseverance and they never give up easily. So these are the various qualities of a successful entrepreneur. Now, functions of an entrepreneur. Rajesh Marwaha and J.S. Mehndipur has given a comprehensive classification of the functions of the entrepreneurs in their book, that is Entrepreneurship and Small Business. Now, children, why I am telling you the names of the scientists, even if you know that this unit, that is your part A, is only of 10 marks. See, one word questions are asked in the board exams. So that can be from anywhere. So I need to teach you even the small things, like the name of the book, the Entrepreneurship and Small Business was, these people, Rajesh Marwa and J.S. Mehndipur, they give a comprehensive classification of the functions of entrepreneur in this book. Now, there are four functions: entrepreneurial, promotional, managerial and commercial. Now, today I'll be discussing only one function, that is entrepreneurial function of an entrepreneur. Now, basically it involves organization, building and management. First of all, what is to be done? In order to open a business, he or she should organize, should plan the things. Hiring of employees, organizing the factors of production, cost, losses, all these things have to be planned. So that will be coming in organization, building and management. The next entrepreneurial function is risk taking. Risk taking is about taking the responsibility. Some common risk and risks entrepreneurs take are return on investment, hiring of new employees, working with vendors, etc. Then next entrepreneurial function is innovation. Innovation means introduction of new concepts, new products, new services, new ideas. Remember, children, an entrepreneur can only be successful if he or she is innovative. You can see in the city there are various restaurants today. But why you people prefer a particular one? Because there you find the new ways of welcoming you people. The decoration, everything attracts you. So this is the entrepreneurial function, that is innovation. Now, just to conclude, I would say that today we have studied about the various activities, the qualities and only one function of entrepreneurship, that is entrepreneurial function. That is all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.